air pressure and density at a point on the wing of a Boeing 747 are 1.32 times 10 to the 5th newtons per meter squared and 1.24 kilograms per meters cubed, respectively. What is the temperature at that point? So let's go ahead and pull out the knowns of the equation. The first known that we have is the air pressure. So the air pressure is going to be 1.32 times 10 to the 5th newtons per meter squared. Now there's also another known here. We have the density of the air. Density we write with a rho. So density is going to be 1.24 kilograms per meters cubed. Now for the unknowns of the equation. The unknown that we have is temperature. We're not quite sure what the temperature is. One of the laws that we use when talking about air properties is called the ideal gas law. Let's go ahead and write down what is the ideal gas law. The ideal gas law is pressure is equal to the density of the air times the gas constant times temperature. If we look at this equation, we have pressure, we have density, we're looking for temperature, and we know the gas constant for air, right? Our question says air up here, so we know the gas constant of air. So what we can do is we can rearrange this problem to solve for temperature. So just doing some algebra, if I want temperature on one side, I have to move density and the gas constant to the other side. So that gives me the equation that the temperature is equal to the pressure divided by the density multiplied by the gas constant. So as you can see, this is going to be a simple plug and chug where we just rearrange an equation and we plug in the values we know and solve for the value we don't know. Go ahead and do that. So I'm going to scoot it over here. Temperature equals, the pressure is 1.32 times 10 to the 5th newtons per meter squared over 1.24 kilograms per meters cubed. These are parentheses. Times the gas constant, which I'll go ahead and I'll throw it up here for your reference. The gas constant for air. The gas constant for air that we're going to use in this equation is 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So let's go ahead and put that into our equation, 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So before we plug and chug, let's just take a look at the units to see if there's anything we need to convert to make sure the units check out. So looking at the top here, I have newtons on the top. I have meters squared on the bottom. Down here I have kilograms on the bottom, meters cubed on the top. Coming over here I have joules on the bottom, kilograms Kelvin on the top. Make that a little clearer. Sorry about my handwriting. Now if you look, kilograms cancel, You have two of the meter squares canceling to leave one on top. So now we have Newton meters, Kelvin over joules. Now 1 joule actually equals a Newton meter. So if we put that in, that conversion factor, you'll notice that the rest of the units cancel and the only thing we left with is Kelvin. So we should be good to plug this into our calculator and expect to get an answer in Kelvin. So let's go ahead and do that right now. And we're going to get an answer of... Now when you plug this into your calculator, you're going to get an answer of 371 Kelvin. And so that's going to be your answer. Make sure you box it. And there you go.